allow me to worship Jukwu Kikrapiam on behalf of the entire family listening right across the length and breadth of this very planet. All of you who are ordained, all of you who are destined to perform wonders, I welcome all of you. Now, I will present you to Jukwu Kikrapiam in heaven. Therefore, our Father who resided in heavens above, looking down upon the pain and the suffering of your children, as was foretold by those who have gone before us, that a day will come when the world will gang up, when all the children of darkness will congregate to prevail against your children. That time is now. We are in pain. We are in so much suffering that man cannot begin to comprehend it. We ask for your mercy. We ask for you to come and present and provide a way where there is none. We ask you, Jukwu Kikrapiam, give me to me a man in the We call upon you this evening. The vultures are congregating. The saboteurs are rising up. We are beginning to identify them. And we are dealing with them. We ask you to give us the strength. We ask you for courage. We ask you for every ounce of determination and resilience to make us as hard as steel, as only you can do. Baptize us in your word, in your knowledge, in your truthfulness, and in your strength. Make it impossible for our enemies to come close to us. Destroy them before they come very close. We will be tempted, of course. Our defenses will be tried without a shadow of a doubt. Sometimes there may be breaches, but in the end we prevail because that is your word and that is your promise. This evening we hold on resolutely to that very command of yours. Your own spoken word. The word that you gave to your children when you said to them that they should not worship any idol, they should not bow before any graven image. We have made mistakes in our lives. We have bowed before you again, idols. We have done everything but worship you in truth and honesty. But now, having realized the errors of our ways, we present ourselves before you that you may do with us as you please. So it was prayed thousands of years ago, that same prayer will be echoed, because we are nothing without you. We are nothing without you. We can have the best defenses in the whole world. We can procure the finest anti-jamming equipment available. But it is you that will defend your inheritance. You will defend your inheritance. You know that we are honest and truthful people. You know that we preach this gospel in the knowledge that your children must be free in the land of the living, that they may go back and worship you in Zion as they have done thousands of years ago. This is our prayer, now and always, because we are your children. You can't abandon us to the forces of evil and darkness. That is not your will. And it can never be. That is why today, tomorrow, and always, as you have called us to undertake this very monumental and a big task, as you have determined that your word must be preached in the land, that very land you gave to our ancestors thousands of years ago, so shall it be done in our lifetime. Allow us to be worthy to serve you. Allow us to be considered worthy to serve. You know we speak the truth. Our enemies are liars. They are cheats and they are killers. They are bloodthirsty bastards, all of them. All of them bar none. They have brought their lives to bear upon all their dealings. Their tongue is very spiteful against those of them who are righteous before your son. Please don't allow shame to befall your children. Don't allow shame to befall your name, because we answer your name, we bear your name. That is why today we make this very prayer in the sure knowledge that Biafra will be restored as your own kingdom upon the face of the earth. That you will be worshipped every blessed day of our lives, as our children will do, and so will their children. Until time everlasting, we have prayed in your name. He said,
Biafran heroes and heroines, remembrance day 2019. Oh yes, my good people of Biafran, our freedom don't be at hand, oh my delicious Biafrans. Once again, the Biafran heroes and heroines, remembrance day don't come again. For Thursday, 30th May 2019, when we do so, now when it go happen, great Biafrans, these heroes and heroines, remembrance day don't become tradition in the history and life of Biafrans worldwide, as other nations they remember their fallen heroes. And so we, the indigenous people of Biafran, IPOB, will remember, honor, respect, and salute our fallen mama, papa, brother, sister, uncle, aunt, cousin, children, even tata and mumboy, when Nigerian government, with her British papa and mama, and her allied forces, massacre for Asaba, over Iwawasa, Mpo, Iwacha, Odi, Aba, Ala Yoruba, Afaruku Ibeku, and other places still unknown mention. These great heroes and heroines will bleed, hunger, thirst, suffer, and die, lay the foundation for our existence today, Thursday, 30th May 2019, as usual, all captains of industry, Nigerian Union of Free Transport Workers, market leaders and their markets, schools, colleges, universities, polytechnics, oil bank companies, banks, transport operators, stubborn keke riders will not get welfare, advice on ourself, filling stations, civil servants, private offices, churches, and ministries, together with other similar organs, for the whole of Biafra land, must obey and observe this hallowed, sacred, and sober day, as we, the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, under the supreme leadership of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, the entire Directorate of States, in conjunction with the Obongalicious good people of Biafra, don't agree and declare, say, Thursday, 30th of May, 2019. Now sit at home, aka Operation Total Lockdown of Biafra Land. We'll give you rebel in the chain and allow Biafra. These Biafran heroes and heroines, remembrance day, when we sit at home, go carry this wise fire enters Aba Abo Igala, Urobigedi Shekiri Ibanke, Ibo Binuzo, or Bobaruge Bejo, and the whole of 25 provinces were there for Biafra land, even as our Biafrans in Ofe Manoland, Yoruba, and Ugoosa go also join in this sit at home. Umbaho, our people in diaspora go carry Egunzo Bunzobu, Biafra Bo Kemba, with all our Ejirimara and electrify the streets of Ambeke and Africa in general. True to Chukwu Kika Biama, this year's Biafran heroes and heroes, remembrance day, go be awkward, but Thursday, 30th May 2019, another history in the making, 30th May 2019, another indelible mark in the sand of time and of history by Biafrans. Join this one big global family for the restoration of Biafra. Makana, house of Fulani Nopanoka, or Bugun Hab Haloka, no talk say, you no hear, or I no tell you. Join IPOB now, because our freedom is gold and silver and gold. Freedom is life. Our freedom is gold and diamond and precious stones. Freedom is here. Now the Obongalicious indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, bring on this message.
Yes, once again, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you, good night, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra, streaming live through Radio Biafra London, being anchored by the deputy leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mazi Uche Okafor-Mefo. He is from Abatiti, and Abatiti is in Anambra, and Anambra State is Biafra land. Is the man who have assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. Most of you will not understand the depth, the weight, and the strength behind that words. Because only few people can survive in a niche, in a country like Nigeria without being corrupted. Only very few men and women. And so when he say, I will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption, you can only imagine the frustration is given to the system of the Nigerian state. He's standing in the deputizing capacity on behalf of our supreme leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, the prince of Afari Ibeku, heir to the throne of Ibeku kingdom. The one man who stood up to speak for the collective interests of the Biafran people in the past 6 decades. Nobody has been able to do that. Because the moment you come up, you say, no, marginalization must stop, intimidation must stop, harassment must stop, point and kill must stop, emasculation, tribalism, nepotism, all these things must stop. You have two choices. He said that you are hunted down like Ken Saro-Wiwa. He said that you are assassinated like Elichi Martin. He said that you are killed like Adakaburu, and so on and so forth. Or you will accept bribe. And then you will be singing Biafra with one mouth. But yet the other mouth, you are a fool Nigerian. Nigerian police are guiding you. No, Nigerian police are the one guiding you. You freedom fighter who want Nigeria that is feeding many criminals across the globe. You will be the one that they are protecting. And you think you are fooling us. We shall know when the time comes. And so when we referend our leader, supreme leader, his eminent, Mazen Nadekano, you should not be jealous. Come and do what you have done. Maybe by now you're all you wear now, your money now. Maybe you'll be on your own private jet. So when I look at these people who say they are achievers as a black man, when I look at majority of them, their hands are soiled in the blood of their people. By the grace of Chukwuka Kabiama, I am George Onibe. I'm from Abo. Abo is a Delta state, and Delta state is Biafra land, for the avoidance of doubt. And I serve the indigenous people of Biafra in the capacity of the African rep and the Nigerian international coordinator. We must move ahead to acknowledge the Almighty Creator, Chukwuka Kabiama, who sits in heaven and presides over the affair of man. Nihi na imara mai ihuna nya ne na ki ubio magi uju anya nya dadu ingwe gimbangwe odi uje dikagi ibu afanu eka anyi ni ni na sina edimau. We are not wasting much of our time. We go on still in the spirit of 30th of May, still in the mood of remembering the fallen heroes and heroines, including the living ones. Our team remain, we will never forget them. We will never forget them. But our topic this morning is those who died in the dispensation of IPOB. Of course, when I say those who died in the dispensation of IPOB, or rather, should I say those who died in the dispensation of agitation, those massacred in the dispensation of agitation, I think it's better that way. Because Owazuriki led thousands of Biafran's youth to their deaths. And today, he's building Nigerian embassy, Biafra embassy inside Abuja. He's building Nigerian Radio Buhari in the guise of Biafra. No, they have Biafra University inside Nigeria in this life, where the name of Biafra terrorized and traumatized Nigerian people. I always tell you, we always tell you, go to your Yoruba pastor and mention Biafra. You will see, you will kick them off the balance. You will know that the name of Biafra is bigger than the name they used to deliver you. What are they afraid of? This morning, we must continue to remember them. Till 30th of May, we must continue to remember them. For the sacrifice of our fallen heroes will never be in vain. And that atrocity of Nigerian against us as a Biafran people will never be forgotten. It will never be blotted away. The only thing that will bring peace is that everybody should go his own way. And then maybe we can be good neighbors. But you continue keeping us in this one Nigeria, you understand that we have been pushed to the war already. And believe me, it's going to boomerang. It's going to boomerang. One thing I have respected Homo sapiens for, not just Homo sapiens, but every living creature of God. They know how to improvise. When they feel threatened, it doesn't matter the time it takes, they develop a defense mechanism. This helps them to fight back. That is why, respective of the hunger that is initiated, making many of us to compromise. But yet some are working very hard to develop a defense mechanism against starvation. Developing a defense mechanism against even death itself. For in the end, we are the one who choose how we will die this day. We've taken time to analyze those who died in different dispensations. But we didn't stop there. It continues. And now we are going to look at those who died under the dispensation of Biafra. How long are we going to keep quiet while they cut us down one after the other? Considering the number of people that have been killed in the last 70 to 80 years, Biafrans. Everybody will agree with me, sincerely, that over 20 million or thereabouts Biafrans have been hunted down. And so they know it's propaganda. If you agree 3.5 million died just 3 years. And so we are along the line, you agree that over 29,000 died just in 1 year. And you agree that over 29 women were murdered by British government in the guise of Aba Women Riot. Could you please take all this record and put them together? I'm not talking about those who are unaccounted for. And then when they come out, they say, hey, the highest in population is Hausa. And now I begin to wonder, where is the Hausa? Because irrespective of the fact now that they are trying to climb down on Biafra people, you see them at the nook and cranny of Biafra land now as a foot soldier, jihadist soldier. How many are they? But even at that, they are just very handful of them. But the amazing thing is that because they have access to AK-47, British government is properly equipping them to massacre our people again if we should march. Well, we will march, but it's not going to be on their tent. Because we said the next one, that bullet that was not shot in Yoruba land, that bullet that was not shot in Hausa land, we shall shoot it there. When you are trying to occupy Biafra land and you're trying to make us feel that, oh, they are going to kill us, you killed us in our land. This time we will die outside the gate. Jesus has to go outside the gate to die. That is when the children of Israel were freed. From bondage, that is when Christians were liberated. Maybe what is remaining is that we will willingly sacrifice ourselves outside the gate of Biafra land. And then so maybe the sacrifice required of us will be complete. So don't get it into your thick head. You will do whatever you want to do in Biafra land, but your land will never remain the same again. For your children and children after them will tell the story of what will happen to your land. So while you are building barracks everywhere in Biafra land, please go back to your land and build barracks. But that is not where we are going anyway. It's just a way of trying to express oneself. Those who were murdered during agitation era will be remembered. Rafael Owazuriki led out many Biafran youth today. But I tell people, when you say you don't want to join IPOB, you are not very fast responding to IPOB. I do not blame people. Because considering what Owazuriki did, it's only those who have Biafra heart will come out and join this struggle. They were busy selling Owazuriki boys. Biafran youth who followed Owazuriki, Nigerian police in Anambra were busy selling their liver and kidney. Go and ask Nigerian people if they will open the record for you. Of course, those are black market. Kill them, dump their dead body in Izu River. Just cycle them, shoot them. Before they die, they remove their liver, they remove their kidney. Depending on the one they want to. Then police were parabolating. Nigerian police were parabolating everywhere with cooler, with ice block. But fighting for freedom, is it a crime? Somebody come and say, you, from today you have become nigger. And you say, yes, we are nigger. Because if I say, you, like our leader said, you have become chimpanzee and monkey, they will say I'm insulting people. But they now say, yeah, you, we are now Nigeria. Yeah, we are Nigeria. And all of a sudden, you discover you are not Nigeria. You discover you are Oduduwa. It's not a sin. You discover you are Arewa. It's not a sin. You discover you are Biafra. Then it becomes a treasonable felony. And then you're hunting us down like animals. You want to force us into this marriage we don't want. You lie. Do what you can while you have the time to do it. Many Biafran's youth unaccounted for was murdered. Owazuriki don't have record of any of them. There is a brother in my unit where I worship in IPOB. One day we were talking, he said to me, do you know I have to leave Aba? Because the Bakassi boys that we actually trained at that time to hunt down Owazuriki boys, we after him. He abandoned everything and he started all over again. And when he told me the story of what he encountered, all his friends who joined Mozob, all of them were hunted down. You think when we come here, we talk, we are not ready for you? You want to hunt us down? We will not give you the privilege. We will not be careless with our lives, but we are ready for everything. Our heart is ready for you already.
You think we don't know the difference between we and you? We value life, you don't value life. And because we value life, you are taking our life. No, you are boasting of your Boko Haram Fulani Hesnem Yati Allah. Soon you will see Biafra Hara, and then we shall know. Chuko Kika Biama, and that's your own God who is actually stronger. Don't worry. You bail up us. They say, hey, don't kill me, don't kill me. You dare to kill them. Very soon, when you bail up us, we say, don't bail up us. Don't shoot, don't bother. Because we have enough bomb, suicide bomber uniform on our body that will exterminate all of you. But you of course, you have monopoly over killing. So continue to kill. Let us see how it will end. You fought, you brought death to our doorstep. Today you parade yourself as a hero. Founding father, we are looking at you. Will you see them, Obasanjo? Will you see them, Late Buhari? Will you see them, T.Y. Danjuma? Will you see them, Badamasi Babangida? Will you see them, Late Abacha? Will you see them, all of them, when they tell you about their history? Go to Nigeria and so they will say, what do they call it? Personality profile. They lie to you. These are terrorists. These are war criminals. These people are supposed to be rotten in jail. But of course, who would see it? Those who would have said it are the people who are responsible. Those people who died because they followed Uwazurike for the sake of Biafra, we will remember them. It's not their fault. They thought Uwazurike was the leader. In fact, was our leader not even following Uwazurike, thinking he was the man who will lead us out? But when they discover how evil he was, all of them backed up. There is a write-up going on in the media. He said, I was kidnapped by Uwazurike. And so we can't blame them. That is why sometimes I say, even those who betrayed Biafra and were hunted down by the Awusa Fulani, Awusa Nigerian master, I don't blame them, because you never know what they experience, what they encounter. Look at today. Many people are working very hard to run that principal officer who are working sincerely. I do not blame them, because they think IPOB is here for buying and selling. And then somewhere along the line, like Uwazurike, we will fizzle out. I never know what is in the heart of our leader. But truly, I must tell you that Chukwu Kikabiam say, no, this man is different and he's going to be different. So when you are working hard and taking that somewhere along the line IPOB become history, you are dreaming and hallucinating, because it could only get better and we shall metamorphose to the next level. Stop fooling yourself. We have given fools so much time to wake up. We have given so much time to sabotage, to come back to their senses. But they are not coming back to their senses. Let us see how much time we have it, because the clock is ticking already. I do not blame them. They want freedom. There is nothing anybody can ask for. There is no greater gift you can give to Biafra's a genuine one at this moment, other than freedom. Something more than good. Something more than good. The freedom of the Biafran people is something more than good. Something more than Gassan oil. Something more than Gassan oil. Something more than good is the freedom of the Biafran people. There is nothing you will give us we will value. Our freedom is that which make money in consequence. But you don't understand anyway. We will remember them. All of them, Uwazurike boys, the one thrown inside the Zoo River, all of them, we will remember them. It doesn't matter what Uwazurike is doing. Today he's eating money now. When you say something to people, say, leave them. Hassari is receiving over $10 million every year. When you say, leave him, does he know how many job people that died? Tomorrow now, Nigeria say, that man there is evil that kill you. He's your man. Tomorrow now, they say, IPOB is killing our youth. But Uwazurike, you will never hear about them. Go to all the Uwazurike building in checking point. Don't you know Uwazurike have checking point? Those of you in Uwinta, you know where Uwazurike checking point, Mozob office is. The house is painted Biafra flag. In fact, Nigerian police are guiding there. But once they catch you, your IPOB, you are in soup. But they will end up in that soup. They died. We will remember them, 30th of May. When IPOB started, on that very day, we were remembering our hero on the Chahed Bridge. We went there, peacefully protesting. We want to remember our dead. We want our freedom. We want to decide through plebiscite or referendum, because many states in Nigeria become Nigerian, like Atiku, like Buhari. They become Nigerian through plebiscite, which is referendum. Many Cameroon land is in Nigeria today through plebiscite, which is referendum. And many Biafra land is in Cameroon today through plebiscite, which is referendum. This is the same thing we ask for. But of course, the reason why you are hearing Nigeria, 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 Nigeria is because of something we don't even know yet. It's something more than you can know. But then we will unravel all of them, every mystery, we will unravel it, and we will expose every atrocity. We say, let's remember them. On that night, that evening, that eve of that very day, we gathered that on the Chahed Bridge. Nigerian Navy, who are supposed to be fighting pirates in the high sea, only in Nigeria you see Navy inside forest. They are swimming desert, only in Nigeria. They were on a Chahed Bridge, including other security apparatus. When you see them, they are jumping as if they are American FBI or trained soldier. These people are, they don't even go to training. Of course, they see an armed IPOB member. They open fire. Late Chimobi Okafor was shot in the hand. And there was a brother there. His name is Chimobi. They shot Chimobi, and another Chimobi came and rescued the life of Chimobi. Late Chimobi Okafor, of course, we will remember them. She was shot in the hand and was almost dying. Another brother called Chimobi, I won't complete his name for security purposes. He rescued Chimobi Okafor. It's unfortunate that Chimobi is dead, and her soul will forever live. All those of you who are saying, hey, Chimobi did this, Chimobi did that, Chimobi did that. Chimobi is dead, though. Come and replace Chimobi. No, come, Chimobi is dead. Come and replace her. All of you have gone mood. Thunder will fire all of you. We know all of you. I respect myself because the privilege I have cannot be abused. But I will not hide any truth from any of you. Then the people say, hey, Chimobi did this. The same way you are saying, now the canoe did this. Hey, This is the way all of you, where are all of you? You become mood all of a sudden. Chimobi is dead. You people successfully poison her. Where are you now? George Oyibi will not give you that privilege. Shame. We will remember all of them. Do you know how many people who died there? There is a lady that was selling clothes that morning in their shop because he served a man who is selling boutique. A stray bullet killed her. And now all those people who died at Onitsha Head Bridge, we will remember them. And I must use this privilege to tell every state coordinator. Don't tell me I was not the state coordinator then. Begin to dig deep. We want the data of all these people. We want all of them. Because some of you think you are a chairman, Minister of Information, Minister of Foreside IPOB Kwano. Go and begin to gather all this information. Because these people's death will not be in vain. And then after the killing of our people in Onitsha Head Bridge, we had another one. Ekenkpo. I was in Ekenkpo. St. Admore Catholic Church in Ekenkpo. On that Heroes Day, like we are going to experience or celebrate on the 30th of May, I was invited then by Chidibe Onwodiwe. The directive was that I should go to that Catholic church, they will pick it up from there. And when I got to Ekenkpo, Opiweka, I called the number that was supposed to direct me to Ekenkpo. The number was switched off. And I called my state coordinator then. Of course, he's still my state coordinator. And I said, I'm in Opiweka now. The person who is supposed to take me to the place I will stay till the 30th of May, that was the eve of 30th of May, the number is switched off. The person said to me, oh, I'm somewhere in Kempo already with one of our members. Come and join us there. That is how I went there. The man is lit anyway. We will remember all of them. It was around 4 a.m., this kind of time or earlier than this, we begin to receive call. Because then I was Biafra Land Deputy National Coordinator. We begin to receive call. They are killing our people in Ekenkpo. They are killing our people in Ekenkpo. I tell you, 1,000 people were slated to sleep in St. Admore Catholic Church. I am sure that not any of them survived. The few we can give account of, some of them are currently undergoing surgical procedure, as I'm telling you. Since 2015, they are still undergoing surgical amendment, operation to amend their, oh my God. Are we talking about what they did? It was in the main hall of this Catholic church. When they came, they on light inside the hall, saw everybody Through each window, they opened fire sporadically, and only God knew if anybody survived. They brought 9/11 truck and packed their dead body away. Nigerian Army were the one who mobbed that blood from that church, and they arrested the Reverend Father in that church immediately. The Reverend Father refused to give account of what happened because they will kill her. They will kill him. But I thought he wanted to go to heaven. Why is he not going to heaven? A grave, a shallow grave or whatever was made in Barak and Anambra, and they buried these people. Who will remember them? I would have been dead. If not that that person's phone number switched off, I would have been in that Catholic church. And maybe I would not be here today. Who will remember them? We went on to Aba High School. We were there to organize to remember our hero. Nigerian Police Army came. They were behaving like commandos. Even dead body, there are video clips on the net already showing Nigerian police searching somebody they've shot, waiting for him to die. The Nigerian police and army are doing picking pockets. They were murdered. We will remember them. Are we going to go to Afaribeku, the invasion of our leader's house? In fact, our leader gave an order, first of all, because the killing continued within 3 days in Tafa. The first day, he said, all roads lead to Afaribeku. We moved. I was in a vehicle. And I'm getting to Isialangwa Junction. I saw where Nigerian police blocked the road. They were searching everybody. And I was in the back seat of a vehicle. I couldn't record properly. I wept that day because I saw IPOB member, Biafrans, drinking mud water, rolling in mud water. Some of them have been shot to death. I saw them. I couldn't record it. I was weeping in my heart. I said, God, how can we tell the world what is happening? My vehicle finally was able to scream and they allowed us to go. There was a trader in that vehicle that I entered. That trader was carrying a tin tomato carton. I was at the back seat, so I used my hand to tear one of the tin tomato basket and hide my Android phone there. So when they were searching me, they only saw one Chiku phone. So Nigerian police, when you are looking for IPB member, please, if you see the person carrying cow, search the whole cow, because sometimes we travel with trailer carrying cow. Adia Mama, Amandia Inezi. That is how I was able to escape that trip. I saw people dying. Finally, we got to our leader's house. I saw jets hoveling, flying around our leader's house. I saw men and women, young men and women, Biafrans, being hunted down like animals. They were fighting us with sophisticated weapons. Military software was displaced that day. Displaced. Even drone was bombing everywhere. Why is Nigeria not talking about it? Oh, they can sip it under the carpet. Do you know that about 28 persons died that very day? We're not talking about those who went into the bush and bled to death. You say we're not going to remember them. In fact, even our supreme leader, Dog Jack, will be remembered. And we remember them 30th of May, sit at home. We go on to Igbocha massacre. I have witnessed it to that. The first rally we underwent, I still know how many people that died there. I was with one, my coordinator was there with me on that very day. They shot him tear gas on the eye. His eye is ruptured. He's still alive as we speak. Maybe he's listening to me. We've not forgotten them. I know that in that first rally, we tried to take about 7 people down to teaching hospital in Port Harcourt then. When we got there, they refused to treat us. And out of these 3 persons we took, there are 5 persons. A coordinator from Ubibu, something in Bu, was the one who actually helped to convey these wounded brothers to the teaching hospital in Port Harcourt. They refused to attend to us. Before my very eyes, 4 of them bled to death, remaining only one. It was midnight. I was exhausted and I have to go home. And that brother continued rescuing them. And when they come to pick the dead body of our people for record purposes, they were stopped. They had information that Nigerian SAS, Nigerian Army, Nigerian Boko Haram were on the way into that hospital because they received a tip-off. They called me that say one of the people, one of them is still alive. What do we do? The vehicle we are carrying now, we have dead bodies on it already. What do we do? I told that brother. I said, that one that is alive, package him as a dead body. Who knows if he may survive? And then they moved these people. As they were leaving the premises of the teaching hospital in Port Harcourt, the Nigerian Boko Haram security department were entering there. So they narrowly escaped. The brother I'm talking about is still alive and is listening to me. He was dropped in tank within Rumukurushi Aziz. And another brother from Cross River State took him, and another sister who is a nurse attended to him. He survived, is alive. But those who died, we will remember them. We will not leave them. That was the first killing in River State. I won't go into what happened later, because it's a case study for another day. When Donald Trump, the president of America, successfully won, considering the fact that Nigeria was sponsoring, what is this woman named? Clinton, what? Hillary Clinton. Nigeria was sponsoring many countries to terrorize, to hack our American database, to leak Obama. I mean, did I say Obama? Including Obama, we were working very hard to leak Donald Trump. But we gave moral support. We gave all our Lord support, according to Baka, when he was giving all our Lord support to lead Buhari to Donald Trump. And we're happy. At least we want this man to be president of America. Maybe we'll see the truth. Maybe he will. Of course, even if Donald Trump refused to talk about Biafra issue, at least for restating the state of Israel and allowing Tel Aviv to become the capital of Israel, Jerusalem, is beautiful and unbelievable. That is a way to go. We came out on the street. We rejoiced, we sang song, Donald Trump, oh, we were very happy. Foreign mercenaries were hired. At different junction, our people were shot. There was a boy, he's still alive. He may still be alive today. He's still listening to me. They shot him, he refused to die. Boko Haram army man took the nearest wheelbarrow, if you know what wheelbarrow is, and began to hit this boy on the waist region. The boy went from one procedure of operation to another, surgical operation to another, because the wheelbarrow cut all the vein within the waist region of this young man. When they connect this vein, it will start urinating, but it cannot go to the toilet. They say the other vein was cut, they will connect it back. But that boy to survive means that there is a purpose. So if he's listening to me, you know there is a purpose in your life. You were meant to die. They actually wanted you dead, but you didn't die. But who is talking about them? No. They come on radio, they deceive you. We are one Nigeria, we are peaceful, we are... But this is an eyewitness of what I'm telling you. I'm not... They didn't tell me now. This one, they didn't tell me. You see, we are one Nigeria, we are men of God and women of Allah and men of Allah. We love peace and we want one Nigeria to come. On the expense of who do you want one Nigeria to continue? We've been keeping quiet all this while. That is why your atrocity have been covered. But now, it is time. The game has just begun. Have it at the back of your mind. We are not in a hurry. Even the looting, current looting ongoing, you will wish you never lead, because we will make that money useless for you. What's set, Yana? And after Igbocha massacre, Donald Trump massacre, we go back to Aba massacre. A lot of shallow side grief was cited in Aba. But nobody's talking about it. They just psycho. In fact, as you are talking, they are still killing our people in Aba. Another Aziz of Biafra land. They just round you up. Oh, how dare you carry IPOB flag? I mean, Biafra flag. How dare you have Biafra flag in your phone? You are a dead man. Why? When you see that, they say, die, die, but I would damn bastard. Why? Wallahi, you are dead. Oh, they think they are hero. They think they are hero. Oh, God. Shadow groups everywhere of our people. Amnesty International will bear me witness. Do we need a forensic evidence to actually find out who these dead bodies are? No, 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 no. But we know our people were killed. We will remember them. We said we are going to organize rally, all road lead to Bayelsa. And the moment we get to Patani, branching into Bayelsa, Nigerian Boko Haram army were there. They stopped every vehicle, arrested everybody. It doesn't matter whether you are a PUB member. As far as you apply that road, apply on that road, the only thing that will save you that day is that you are Yoruba. You can say, hey, Joy Shanu Miolua, or you are Awusa. You can say, ah, Kachiko Ineje Kanamaku. Without that, they lie them in a swamp. What do they call this swamp? It's called the sucking blood. I do not know the botanical name, but locally we call it sucking blood. They were sucking blood inside those water. Our people were meant to lie down there. They start lying down in this muddy water from something around the around 10 in the morning, and most of them lie in that water even over the night. They were total lockdown. Many people died. We can remember the likes of David Enam, who survived that very hideous crime against humanity. But many people died. We will remember them. Are we talking about the adoption? Who knows if Justice Udeh is still alive? Because they would have killed him. Are we going to do anything? Maybe no, but certainly yes. But we know he's alive. But if they've killed him, there is no problem. Many more we have to suffer. Many more we have to die. So don't ask me why. There is a natural mystic flowing through the air. I won't tell you no lie. Things are not the way they used to be now. This could be the first trumpet. Might as well be the last. Many more we have to suffer. Many more we have to die. Don't ask me why. For those of you who think that the war is over here in Biafra land, you have to think again. Think again. Something is wrong. You have to rethink. Anyway, our target at the moment is to remember all of them. We will remember all our fallen heroes. I'll be back in a minute.
We are Biafra.
We love Biafra.
We love Biafra.
We love Biafra.
Our father's
land.
We love and cherish.
Yes, at this moment our lines are open. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our WhatsApp line remains 070-815-45642. For the last time, our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. The special number dedicated to the female is 081-288-58614. Special number dedicated to the female is 081-288-58614. Special number dedicated to the female, the women is 081-288-58614. Like I said, those in Biafra land should begin to get ready. I will not forget to remind you that Nigerian government, in the quest to steal killer people, are going about secretly to provide what they call water treatment or borehole treatment plant. They are planting this very poison inside borehole in every school in Biafra land. If you are owner of a school, you are a school proprietor, you are a school head teacher, you are a school principal, please don't give the water to our children to drink. Yoruba and Hausa now are looking for another way to put imbecilic disease in the system of our children. They are going everywhere telling you they are NGO. They want to give you a water treatment plant. Please do not accept it. Do not accept it. The Ebola did not work. Chicken pox did not work. Cow pox did not work. Every attempt before now to begin to initiate this systematic killing of our people did not work. Now they didn't publish it. It's not in the newspaper. They are secretly calling the owners of school now. MTN is giving them your data. So in case they call you, don't be surprised how they got your number. MTN is the one giving them their data. Let me tell you what you don't know. I registered my MTN line with my company's name. But MTN changed it recently to George Onyibe African Rep. MTN, did I register my SIM with George Onyibe African Rep? I registered it with George Interlock, Royal Paver Interlock. Why are you changing my name? When we tell you that the people we are fighting are so many, most of you don't know. So don't bother how they will get your name. As far as you have BVN, as far as you are part of, you have MTN network, they are dealing with you. Well, we are coming for all of them. It's bit by bit, because we will not fight all of them at the same time. You will not understand. You say, oh, how did they get my name? How did they get my number? Don't you have BVM? Aboki get BVM. That time on Atisio, now they advance. Where they give them your fingerprint. But I don't blame you, because the system is actually designed to wipe us away. So I don't blame you. That time you are giving them BVM, you are signing your death warrant. That time you have MTN SIM card, you are signing your death warrant. MTN, one day you will tell me why you changed my data without my permission. DSS know I own that line. All the Boko Haram apparatus security guys in Nigeria know I own that line. I'm not dropping that line. Track that line. Follow that line. Kill George Onyibe. We shall see how we end for you. But let it be on record. I didn't register George Onyibe African Rep. Because when I bought that line, I was not African Rep. IPOB, I'm not even head of IPOB. Oh, you are collecting my data. But what am I saying in effect? All those of you who have to register, they are going to call your line. Don't be surprised. Those of you who did not register your school yet, they will still send those their area boys to look for you. Yeah, you think they are doing you favor. Since when did Nigerians start caring about the water we drink? When more than 90% of those in the coastal region are drinking from the same water they urinated, the same water they pass visits in? Use your head. Shine your eye. If you like, you hear. If you don't like, don't hear. Mothers and father, tell your children not to drink water from the school. Buy, look for Ragoli's water, any Konkon, put water for them, let them go and drink. Because this is their plan, it will not work. But in case you feel like dying, hey, please drink that water. Accept it. But even if it's only 10 Biafrans remaining, we will never give up. We will never abandon this quest. Caller on WhatsApp, can you hear me? Caller on WhatsApp, can you hear me?
I think he's not ready to speak. Caller on the line, are you there? Caller on the line, can you hear me?
Caller, good morning, sir.
Good morning, this is female line. You should not be calling it. It's female line. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
Good morning. My name is I'm from Alexandria. Good morning, President of Libya. Good morning, our African.
Go ahead.
Good morning, Madam and the panel. Well, this is the director of the reform. The public school is less than a single one of you. Let me move on, protect you, guide you, and do to your present and your life. They will remember that 30th of May in the Christmas world. Remember our new and growing. Everybody in the upper land and in the Castro should put a new effort to see that we will have this our new and growing. We wait for them that Sukhothra Dhamma will be with us, can keep this our end. For those who are not ready, therefore should seek at home. Whatever you are doing, take care of or Kaba, make it careful, root better, everybody, farmers, teachers, whatever you call yourself, wherever you are, remember that this problem is not about us in the world. In the essence, in their life, whatever you do, you must answer for it. Therefore, in this world, each and every one of us should put them together for the expression of that. May God bless all the entire member society holding federal officers who are working continuously to prove that Biafra is forward moving. May God Almighty dispute Ghanaian protector in this our leader, Madam and the Kano, who can therefore not believe it, and all people who are in support of this trouble, and the freedom and independence of us, they shall be belong and see Biafra in very much closer to I pray.
Isi, thank you very much. We must continue. Yes, a caller on the line. Your name and where are you calling from? Caller on the line. Caller on the line.
Good morning.
Good morning, please. Your name. Your name and where are you calling from?
My name is Amitu. I'm calling from Mukwacha. And thank you for whatever you are doing for us. So thank God who gave man to man the time to be built from these circles of darkness.
Of course, the Epileptic Network must continue. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from? Good morning.
Good morning, my brother. I'm coming here from Abaya. One day, I'm going to go to the house. I'm going to go to the church of May this month, long start home. Especially in the Naba here, where I have been at that day, I have had a MP, a car had a MP, shopping center had a MP. I don't know what I'm going to go to the church of May, long start home, where I'm going to go to the church. And now I'm going to leave my case to a woman. Can I make all of the other women that are happy? Whether my worry is me, or why I want to leave my case? Or why I want to leave my case? If we stay, can I make all of the other women? Now, that's what I'm me. Or why I want to leave my pain? If we stay, chairman, you never know if we stay. Or I want to leave my pain, and that's what I'm me. Ndị Enugu, ka ị na-emekọ ọrụ ọgba ete Enugu, ji German over well. Our Kulawa, a member of the Patriot of May, across the Afro land. A working for Lucha, an umbra. Then they make one of their women, or where I have two points of a penny. I know two points, and I am making a Patriot of May. This one. Any German, play this over, this father, Martin and the Canon. Donald Chaman no wola o se tra chama oni ma yo wola me di to be di to da ndi biafra aga e ga no mo lo nya o anya da abo nya ni ga me ya mo nya na ga o me ya dot o ya mo na lo di la ti e wo ta bu to a ni le di to go a ko ti da fra la ni wo da mo ni mo ste chama no wa ni mo ste aga wola. Now I'm ready to obey this order. Me pa aya in the street. Onya ma awula kabotura yule biafra. Me do la re mba my people. Ndu mu noa. Omwe ya anwa di amigwe. Anwa di amigwe aga azuna 30th of May. Ndu mu noa. O di amigwe aga emeka na 30th of May. O mpolo to. O hapo hata. I want your mark. Ma te pour ma une ou une pour ma boule une pour ni ma donne de ma garde go ahead we are supporting you no no le mona won won le na na to be supporting you from here in aba we are supporting you ma na de kala wa kinda o wo ni o da ni da we da me u governor me mu clear o me throw o fa ti mo ni bo ma na de kala ni ti a leader ma na de kala ni ti a leader. What I mean, we know we are reaching in your way and I see a man that is coming if you are leader. What do you do? I'm stopping here. The men, let the look from here in our back.
Thank you very much. For you. We must continue. Go ahead. Caller, what's up? Are you there?
Yes, good morning, Mazin.
Good morning, go ahead, please.
I greet my fellow BR friends all over the world. And I want to use this opportunity to remind us that 30th of May is when we remember our heroes. Those of you in Biafra land, please sit at home and do the needful. Those of us that are in diaspora, my name is Okwagu. Okwagu is from Abi. And at the moment, I am the PRO for Indigenous People of Biafra in Sweden, in Stockholm. And I want to use this opportunity to invite those of us that are listening right now to the center of Stockholm City on the 30th of May, which is going to be a red day over here. A red day means it's going to be a public holiday. And we're going to be at Segeltorp. Segeltorp is in the middle of the city. Those of you that have access to IPOB Stockholm, on Facebook, we'll see our contact details and also see our publication, notification towards our gathering. Last year was a wonderful year as we remembered our fallen heroes. They also remembered us and we are growing and we are excelling. This year we remember them again on a red day. On a red day meaning it is a holiday over here. So let us come out, congregate and light a fire. That will make them understand that we are remembering them. Those of you in Biafra land, sit at home and enjoy yourself. Remember our people. Mazenibe, I want to thank you. I will find other opportunities to call on your program to remind our people. Those of them that are listening in the secret, those of them that are Biafrans that refuse to join this, you know, struggle, that will help us to achieve a better future for our unborn. I thank you.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from? Caller on the line.
Yeah, good morning, Mazen.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
Good morning to all. Yeah, good morning to all Biafra. My name is Nessa Chikomaya Sebe. I'm the deputy coordinator. I just want to thank you for what you are doing for your country. Where the mob is your elder. And which people continue to strengthen you day by day and cover you with his glory and his protection and your family. I want to thank all dear friends who are in hard court for their quest for restoration and thank our supreme leader, our Lord Nandu Kawu and his deputy. I pray that you take care and continue to strengthen them and protect them and empower them and give them the glory to march forward until our country is restored. I want to speak to our people, especially in the Biafra land. I want to thank them so much for what they have been doing. They have been sitting at home. They should not forget they have done it before. It's not that you are pleading to them. They know what they're supposed to do. Everybody in Biafra land, even me, my uncle went for war. They all paid the sacrifice. So we should not in beyond them. Here we are. They also remember their heroes. Why can't we remember our own? We have been doing it and we continue to do it until Biafra is restored. So they should not see that something that is a burden. It's not a burden. They should do it with joy. They should do it, you know, with so much, trying to appreciate them. Because it's not easy. I didn't even know that for us. We cannot do it. That's why I said Biafra is an ideology. If they not tell this idea, we should not carry it on. And I believe and I trust Scripture that this our generation will restore Biafra. We are not going to carry it in the next generation. To take care and we help our director, we help all of us, we bring it to pass in our lifetime. All of us will see their fight. No, but nothing should happen to you. I thank you care for your life, continue what you are doing, it is well with all of us. We are fashioning, so well done, my brother.
Thank you. Keep on keeping up. The journey Bye. Has just begun. Thank you very much, Adadino Rama. We must continue. Yes, caller on WhatsApp, bye for now. Can you hear me? WhatsApp, are you there?
Hello.
Go ahead, please.
Hello. Okay. Hello. Good morning.
Good morning, Ma. Go Hello. Ahead, please. Good morning, Ma. Go ahead.
I'm in Kumaka, 30th of May. Oyo bula gano nolo ya. Onye ga-apụta ezi hapụ ga ndị iberibe a gara were ihe a si na igbo a na-eme igbo dee na 30th of May gaa nara ego ka anyị na-achọta chineke ga-etinye otiti chineke anyị ebilitela imegide ha ọ ga-emegide ha mbọchị ahụ ọ ga-emegide ha n'ụtụtụ megide ha n'ehihie megide ha n'abalị chineke agaghị ekwe ka atụmatụ ha nwee isi ihe ndị a ka m na-ayọ na aha Chukwu Okike Abiama
You see, thank you very much. We must continue. Caller on the line, can you hear me?
Hello, good morning, Matthew Joseph.
Good morning, go ahead, please.
I still remember the only motive to do it here. I'm calling from, I'm calling from up back in my depression.
Well,
I greet you, good morning, everybody. I go to my deputy now, the Ujero Kafama Show, and all my sisters, because I am not met all of you. Then, my people here in Napa, is not only to call on radio and remember our people, go to villages, go to the streets, where we are doing your business. Tell people about it that you're not that new. Tell them so that all of us want this thing together. We are in Atta, we are showing you. We are going to show every Atta. Everybody will see that same on that side. We are going to remember our own. Okay, the first point is that day we went to our leader house. We are in Yomwe. I'm among those who can stop at the Alangwa Junction. I've got my habit. We have got them. And when we went to Opera Square, at a number of places, they worked on her. They used a quarter and looking up after us. But God said, well, some of us are injured. Some of us are dead. We are going to remember those people. We are not going to leave them like that. They are our own. So let's take everybody. Call your people from the village. And for me, though, I'm a people, you know, though, I'm not hearing their voice. See, I'm so confused about that voice. When I went to village last time, I talked to them. I still tell them, let them come up and join the trouble so that we will restore our father. Now, well, thank you. I just want to stop the letter.
Thank you very much. 30th of May, sit at home in Biafra land. Can you hear me call on the line? Good morning. Go ahead, please.
My name is Jimmy. I'm calling you from Minister President Biafra land. I just want to pray and also thank you, Kajama, for it has helped that for my love, it has become a success. So, all are in the turn around to come and to start going to meet the partners to tell them that they are not against partners to me. They are not against partners to me. They are with IPOB. And they will celebrate their heroes that are dead. I want to thank you for them. I want to thank you for the good work you are doing. For all these teachings, I tell you, Nchiku Kadama bless you. Nchiku Kadama bless all Jaffas. Nchiku Kadama bless all the principal officers. I can't name all of them. Nchiku Kadama bless all of them all. Nchiku Kadama bless our spirit leader, Mazunam Dikam. Nchiku Kadama bless our deputy leader, Ocean Mosfor. Nchiku Kadama bless you, my dear Jenita, and protect you in this Biafra land.
Thank you very much.
Nothing will happen to us.
Continue.
We will move and see Biafra. The name of Nchiku Kadama.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Yeah. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
Hello?
Go ahead. Good morning. Your name and where are you calling from?
Yeah, my name is Kipe Mekatani. I'm calling from Iwata. I'm from Umanya province. My dear, I love the program. I pray that God bless you and bless all the principal officers, those who have been working at UWM to make sure that we restore our land. I want to use this opportunity to tell people here in Obi, because last year they saw what happened, that everybody should be at home. And we are going to encourage our administrators to make sure that we come up and be able to make sure that all the whole people, either with broadcast or evangelism, we need to make sure that everybody comply. And I want to call my people in who communicate today in Omanya province. Because can I allow me to use my dialect?
Go ahead.
Thank you very much.
We must continue. We want to go home. nothing more, nothing less. But then those who died for us to be alive, your sacrifice will not be in vain. Your sacrifice will not be in vain. Call on WhatsApp, can you hear me? Call on WhatsApp. Call on WhatsApp. I really don't know what is wrong with your life. You always call me, and each time I pick your call, the same thing happens. Maybe you check your line. Call her on the line, your name and where you're calling from. Call her on the line.
Call her on WhatsApp, can you hear?
Call her on the line, your name and where you're calling from.
Hello.
Good morning, go ahead, please.
Okay, good morning.
Go ahead.
Hello.
Go ahead, please.
Yeah, I'm calling from I'm a Vietnam there, okay, from Mumbai province. Listen, I want to advise my people in the Navy to make sure at 30th of May, everybody is at home. And Navy motor park, Navy the material, everybody should sit at home. If I want to use my dialect to talk to them.
Go,
hello?
Go ahead, please.
Okay. I think in the Navy, I would have a Navy, a current Navy, a Moodin, Navy, which is in my head, and I'm going out of the law. On the new, I started off my. Now, I'm not going to be a particular person, not for when I'm out of the law. When I'm out of the law, I'm going to die in the car. Marana, I was a fool and in a river. I was indeed a river. And though I can come on the run or both of them. I know why organized. Then they will know that you are not dead. And I'm a human, you're a bull and a general. If you were to have a maybe to be a poor man, you must have to take a good part of ourselves. I have nobody is thinking mama. So I will not talk to her. I will not talk to her. People don't listen to advice and other things. If I am a human, I will not be a target of me. I will not be in a man because everybody knows this day. There is a brand day for our heroes. Don't allow. That's the one I will not know. That day, when I will find out, I will take care of them.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Call on the line, your name and where you calling from.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Morning, Ada.
Because I bless you, bless your family. My name is Victoria Udibe. I'm calling from Abakaliki province.
Go ahead, please.
I'm a vice woman leader in local government. I feel good, man. Together, I bless you and bless your family. I want to speak with my dialect.
Go ahead, please.
Thank you, man. Goodbye. I know why they send the IPOB to my target of me. I get sick at home. I get medical training too. When I think I treat poor people, they are my friends. Because every morning, do I have to manage my Monday calo? Because if I manage, who can I trust? Na, I can't trust no one. Na, I'm doing an experience in a ICUD. I'm doing an abombaka. They are from Asia. Can you wear a long man? Can you not wear any number? When I say no, I do not man or so. I saw me growing into me. Kenele munandio, kenele mumadi nandio, bogo nandio bogo, onye mere ya mere mado. Kenele mu uche mefo, kenele mu uche mefo, bogo uche bogo, onye mere ki mere mado. Kenele mumadi nibe, kenele mumadi nibo, bogo nibo bogo. Onye kipagi kipa mmadu. Oga diru muna mana ya hachupo kika biyama. Ise, ise, ise.
Bye-bye.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Call on WhatsApp. Are you there? Good morning. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, I'm coming from Germany.
Go ahead, Adinoram.
Elizabeth.
Go ahead, please.
I'm inside my village waiting. Preach on the 14th of Panima. Because after the Biafra, only the 7 years during the Biafra War of 1960. And my two uncles, Barawa Biafra. And Ogehan Lapara. Banga Dohamuna Aga Biafra, but Ogehan Lapara. The thing is written because maybe experience. Our son, Yoruba, that I have no blame in Hindu Biafra. I've been playing with her for 2 years. Because, okay, my uncle had water during the Biafra war. I'm in a room, because I'm a whole Juku. You have an alcohol, okay, had water, only 10 years after the Biafra war, only 10 years. Even my uncle had a good hand of power. Merengini jebu semaga. Merengini jebu semaga. Obodu negu ojuku no nelugu negu. Merengini jebu semaga. Ndobu la mende bia piafra gata hako ya de krimchina. Even tito de mwa Germany, akamka gato, yeah, akamka gato England. Because England, you hate him, and you did the Biafra war. All of us in the supermarket is or something. Even here they are British flag in Manila. I immediately literally go that thing, Biafra Biafra maybe, I just dropped me up at that thing in Africa. Oh my God, say, Mama, why you leave her now? As I remember Biafra with a big fire. This is talking about 9 years ago. And even did they happy with you, George Enibe. Even did they very, very happy with you now. You are learning anything, but you know any Senuku. You know any Senuku, you see. You know? And all the money Senuku, even through the 17 years in YG, 1977, come to me. All the money Senuku. Even the Senuku, not for money. You have to come to me. Not for how long I was at. You just saw who is running on a Japan money because I had Jim Wilkoko. Aha, only a little Jim DK. I saw a long way Japan money. Don't give me Kununas, over in the Kununas.
That is brainwash of Nigeria.
Yeah.
These people did their work well. Over 200 years they recondition our people. Over 200 years. You see, Igbo man denying his identity. He's a Niger Delta.
My grandfather, all a reverend to Methodist Church. My grandmother is so man. That's why you bet it. We don't want to maintain the Biafra that I've only been in for 2 years. I believe in God. And my grandfather, Savu Chineke, because my grandfather, when he went to Methodist Church in Anaba, he was Allah, he Chineke. Let alone. All you preach in Germany near our country, say thank God, no Germany come not. All you make sure you're preaching, I go out and take you, say my German man. German man, say my mama. Now, look how Nahana Azama, Nahana Tokorego, na church.
But you know, if you're not seeing all these things, we are making all these reports. Some people say, oh, it's propaganda. It's propaganda. How do you know? It's beating their
imagination. Yes, I'm talking about judge anything. Oh, I don't say no, but don't remember. Eh? That thing, eh? Even I hear my all this ordinary before. I'm a man who's weak.
Of course, they are in Britain Museum now, and our people are paying millions to go and watch what Yoruba churches are condemning. ROC they took from Biafra land, as they call them, is in British Museum, and our people are paying millions to go and look at it.
So that thing with them to hear Master Chineke, because after your hour, you do Kerechi. I think that's a lot of the thing. Yeah? So, okay, my people, you know, you just say, ah, Chineke is number one for me. You put Chineke, my father, and do Kerechi. My grandfather has Sabu Chineke, and I'm a Sabu Chineke. Oh, this is there. And I want to name the Nigerian Sabuna. I don't make a little bit of Chineke, the Lala Nukerechi. Because we have a far more experience. Listen, I'm there, ever have this, even I've ever. Nga minde Nigeria bia zai yitim, uye zino ma koko, mehu. Eh, ananda kwa hasita ha gruda teni da wana abreba. Aya abreba gruda ga teni aba usiebu. They will not come back. Ana kwa choma ata maana, nina ane zoro me zoro mdi 7 years.
But when I was saying it, some people will say it's propaganda. Awosa leprosy, Awosa Fulani and Yoruba, raping our women before their brothers, their fathers, and their
mothers. Listen, I'm 7 years, I'm in 1967, I'm in 1960. My grandfather, my grandfather is a reverend, in a Methodist church. I'm a Nimoza, I'm a Yasa, I'm a
Yes. If you notice my study ongoing, I said,
yeah.
Even after the war, even as we speak, the war is still raging. Immediately they say the war is over, they made a false promise and say 3 arrows. Reconstruction, reintegration, and what is the next arrow? Reconstruction, rehabilitation, and reintegration. None of them, they were false promises. They hide under these guys and start killing our people. The same thing they are doing till this moment. And our people can't even see it. But then,
no one, we see it. George Eni Ibe, George Eni Ibe, 59 years now, when I'm 1960. I'm not sure how many years. To God, I'm telling you, because even in England, I'm ready for them. Really?
It is where we must continue.
India. Yeah, India. India, the bad. Yoruba, now, Alosa. Yoruba.
They are pretending.
Yoruba. I got a hobo. Where did you get? Kim and Ojiku, Ojiku, Nadia, the boss, my mother, and I got Ojiku, Bia, and I my mother, and I soon did it. Ojiku, my mother, and I got the meeting. Ojiku, Kumuna. Yoruba, now, Alosa, I got a hobo. I'm all wrong on the business of a hand wrong or what? Because I got a lot of love. These 2 people got a lot of love. That was so bad. We were happy because you were in Yabo. Because before 1977, and I come on you.
This is how bad it can be. Even the side you're talking about on Aniocha, even Yabo people will be telling Aniocha people then, Ndizibo. I don't know if you have heard that language. Ndizibo.
Ndizibo.
Ndizibo. Oburo ndi Igbo na anyi wa wu ndi Igbo no na Delta anyi no na former Bende State anyi wa na ene emezike onwe nyi nkewa na akpo ndi awu ndi Igbo ndi awu ndi nka ndi awu ndi the Nigerian state, British government, actually, you see, when I begin to look at what the British are doing, I watched a documentary, how they were teaching parrots to talk. And they also compared it to how they were torturing the blacks during the slave trade era. Then when they catch you as a black man, they want to speak plain English for you, you cannot understand. Then they will take a cane and begin to beat you. You must repeat that thing or they will beat hell out of you. And then somebody said, why do you have to torture them to speak your language? And he said to them, if I can make the parrot to say God bless the queen, and then certainly I can make this nigger to say God bless the queen. And when I see people who are very proud of their English and the fune they command, I could only see somebody who is living in the shadow of misery of his past. It's too much to talk about, I must tell you.
But so Chineke ma why otu am I pass school no only ten ka had na the whole Germany yozala so obo na be for we should not strike to da be na ti to be for stand here forget you and the awosa me Chineke da ba you me.
Thank you very much. These are children of Satan among us. Not all of us. Makanetu mwa ni legi wa iburu unye iburu ajo mwado. Oburu andi igbo nine. Onwe ndi igbo obu onwe kwenso. Children of Satan. That is why DNA is very important. Considering how many women they rape, don't you know their blood is among us? Now, Zachikuma, do you know? I discussed with somebody yesterday. He said, when you talk about this DNA issue, I take it very seriously. He said, do you know in my family we have a Yoruba Igbo? We have a Hausa Igbo? He said, in his family, he's from Anambra. He said, when you look at them, he's afraid of them. The moment they grow up, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, they will send them to Sokoto or Kaduna for baptism. Once they come back, when they contest for election, of course, you are sure of express. So, if we agree, it's our people that are bad. Then all of us are going to die. Not all of us, but there are children of Satan in our midst, product of rape. We will
settle.
All those bastards in our midst. The idea was, I don't want to hear Biafra. Watch all of them. Their blood is not pure.
Like all the time, I believe the only Biafra experience. The 7 years will be. The 10 years will end.
This is where we draw the curtain for this segment this morning. Our people must know everything they've done to us, they think we don't know. So when you see a Biafran saying, I'm not a Biafran, I'm Niger Delta, I'm Delta Niger, watch them. They are saying the truth. DNA will set this different. DNA test, we know who is really a German. You cannot hate your father. Our people will say, Ninonya Janjono, no matter how bad your mother food is, you will always eat it with satisfaction. So when you see somebody who is a Biafran, he say, and that a Biafran, he's a holy Ghanistic, he say, watch that person, I will sign Yoruba blood is what is speaking through them. I stand up from here, remain blessed, remain focused. For 30th of May is Sekosan. They won't know.
This is my song for freedom.
He tastes the
peace. They call me Chris Jokey. Even though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I fear no evil, for still God damn is always with me.
us to be coming home. Yeah. We made it through the sun to home. We gave our blood to redeem our land. And the time is too late. To join me, let us get it on now. To happiness, we all rejoice. We are the children of God. I am talking about a holy land, yeah, where God will always reign, and the sun will shine again. So we the people rejoice, yeah, where no one will tell me, yeah, that my son is beside us. I will lose my life for singing songs where there is freedom of speech. Mr. Mefor will remind us, yeah, that we are children of the Most High God. In Jerusalem we meet again, yeah. Cause we are, yes, we are the children of God. And the song will rise. My brothers will be coming home, yeah. We made it through the songs to come. We gave our blood to redeem our land, and the time is too late. To join me, let us get it now. To happiness, we all rejoice. Yes, we are, yes, we are the children of God. We are praying for the moment, yeah, when heaven will come for us. And the world will talk about us, so no one else has to die. All this nation will respect us, yeah. Understand we just wanna go back home. No amount of contest, no show, yeah. Cause we all got possessed, and the spirit is in me. My director will return home. Show us love is too beautiful. Beautiful faces I will see again. Yeah, we need you, we miss you, and we wait on you. And the sun will rise. My brothers will be coming home. Yeah, we made it through the songs to come. We gave our blood to redeem our land, and the time is too late. To join me, let us get it now. Our happiness, we all rejoice. Yes, we are, yes, we are the children of God. Oh,